Hello, my name is Michael, and our presentation is about the implementation of ESP NOW protocol in indoor applications. So we will go through some content about smart indoor applications, then some comparison about or comparison of ESP NOW and Wi-Fi. We will go through some concept of network that we designed and results, and at the end we will have some conclusion and recommendations for you to implementation of ESP NOW protocol. Our team is from Department of Technical Cybernetics, from the Faculty of Management Science and Informatics, University of Žilina. Our department enjoys a field of study computer engineering, and most of the applications of students or research projects are based on ESP32 modules or development boards. So let's talk about some smart indoor applications, some real-life applications. Smart applications brings up interconnection of multiple sensors via wired or wireless connection. A basic concept of a smart application consists of some measurement unit, some processing unit, or and some actuator unit. So measurement unit consists of some microcontroller or microprocessor with connected sensors. Then we have the processing unit, which is mostly some high performance microcontroller or single board computer, maybe some cloud system. And then we have a actuator unit, which can be probably heating, cooling, watering, or lighting. So on the left picture, we can see some device concept or some node of a smart application that have some sensors. It can have some user input for configuration, and then it can have some output for actuator unit probably, and it communicates with some central point or some cloud. On the left, on the right picture, we have a design of a network with multiple devices that are connected to the central point, and the central point is communicating with cloud. So some examples about or some examples of smart indoor applications. It can be smart lighting, smart plugs. It can be air quality monitoring with air recovery, or some soil moisture monitoring with water control. Then it can be some machine status monitoring, inventory management, player tracking, for example, tracking players in a laser game or escape room, or some search or rescue systems. We can use some wired or wireless communication. Wired communication is mostly used between microcontrollers or microprocessors and sensors. It can be UART, I2C, or SPI. And then we have wireless communication that is used between sensor nodes or nodes and processing unit and cloud, and mostly is used Wi-Fi, Zigbee, Bluetooth or Bluetooth low energy for low power applications, then Matter, Thread, and ESP NOW. About some most used wireless protocols. Wi-Fi, it has 2.4 gigahertz and 5 gigahertz frequency bands. Range is up to 30 meters. Then we have Zigbee, that is uses industrial, scientific, and medical radio bands, including also 2.4 gigahertz, or 915 megahertz in America and 868 megahertz in Europe. It has range of 10 or 20 meters indoors, but it can be extended through the mesh networking. Then we have a Bluetooth or Bluetooth low energy, which is also 2.4 gigahertz band and a range of 10 or up to 100 meters. And the last is ESP NOW, which is also 2.4 gigahertz band, and the range is around 200 meters. So let's talk about some comparison of ESP NOW and Wi-Fi. Wi-Fi provides connection of the device to the internet over wireless connection. It's universal, implementable for any device supporting 2.4 gigahertz frequency or 5 gigahertz. It supports many protocols such as UDP, TCP, HTTP or HTTPS, FTP, and it supports all variants of network architecture like mesh, peer-to-peer, star. About ESP NOW, it's implemented on ESP 8266 and ESP 32 based modules. It provides only peer-to-peer communication up to 20 peers per device. And also buffer is limited to 250 bytes. So let's compare them. Wi-Fi can provide communication with various type of systems. So if you are using Wi-Fi, you can communicate with every device that supports Wi-Fi, any developers or development modules for any company. When you are using ESP NOW, you can communicate with systems based only on ESP modules. Wi-Fi has also high latency. ESP NOW has low latency. Wi-Fi has uplink like 554 megabits per second, and ESP NOW is up to 250 kilobits. About the range, Wi-Fi is up to 30 meters and ESP NOW is up to 200 meters indoor. Wi-Fi has a higher power consumption with for ESP32 modules during the connection to the Wi-Fi, it can have a peak of 1.5 amperes, and the ESP NOW has lower lower power consumption. It has during the sending it has 100 milliamps. Wi-Fi is also mainly for internet connection, so sending to some cloud, some REST API, some server, and ESP NOW is designed for IoT, some low power application. So let's talk about the concept of our data evaluation. So what was the motivation of this project? We wanted to evaluate range and packet loss or latency of the ESP NOW protocol for indoor applications. So according to placement in the building and also according to change of environment. It has a use case in a smart classroom project of our students. So the concept of the network, we have like eight nodes, sensor nodes, communicating via ESP NOW with a central unit, and the central unit harvest data and send it through the Wi-Fi to the ThingSpeak. So sensor nodes has been ESP32 based device that simulates sensor data, and the central node is ESP32 S3 and ESP32 C6 combination. These two modules communicate via UART. So sensor nodes sends data to the ESP32S3, and it sends via UART to C6 and send it to ThingSpeak. Sensor node is also implemented in MicroPython, so we wanted to evaluate that is not it don't it not depend don't depend depend on some implementation or some programming language, and it has also ability to change channel or power of the signal by request of a central unit. Then we have central node. Both parts, like C6 and S3 part, is implemented in C, C++. ESP32S3 is able to send the request for change of channel of the nodes and also power of the signal of the nodes. And ESP32C6 is just receiving the data from ESP32S3 and send it to ThingSpeak. So maybe you can ask why the, we use two modules for this central node. It's because that when you are connected to the router via Wi-Fi, and you have implemented also Wi-Fi and also ESP NOW, they are sharing the antenna. So if you are connected to the router, it uses like 90% of time. So it the packet loss increases. So it's like only 10% of time for ESP NOW. Concept of device placement. On the picture we can see a map of the department and also placement of the nodes. So the central unit is in one office and the nodes are in the other classrooms on our office. So we can predict that it has another signal quality due to multiple walls and structure between the peers. So we came to the results. So some evaluation of packet loss and signal strength. So evaluation of the packets. Evaluation of the packets has been done by counting the packets in period of time. So we have a stable frequency of sending. Relative reliability or latency is calculated like a ratio of received packets and expected packets. And packet loss is calculated by ratio of non-received packets and to expected number of received packets. Exactly the implementation was that we have been sending packets every 250 milliseconds, so basically 4 packets per second, and the expected number of received packets was for 30 seconds, so it was 120 packets with 0% packet loss. In first comparison, I have marked on the image, on the picture, the nodes that have been evaluated. So we have central unit and we can see node 1, node 2, node 3 in the right top corner of the classroom, and node 4 in the office. On the graph we can see packet loss during the time. So you can see that node 1 has approximately zero packet loss, 0% packet loss. Also node 4 and node 2 is debatable. So it has sometimes it has less packet loss, sometimes it's like 100% packet loss. And also node 3 is almost 100% packet loss. In the second comparison, we have another four nodes. So we have node 5, node 6, node 7 in the other corner of the classroom, and node 8 And on the next graph, we can see that only node 6 has approximately zero packet loss, and the others have almost wall time 100 or really high packet loss. The last comparison is for best latency, and the lowest packet loss has been achieved by nodes 1, 2, 4, 6. So it was the nearest one. So on this graph, we can see that only node 1, node 4, and node 6 has approximately zero packet loss, with one peak in node 6. And only node 2 has a packet loss somewhere between or around 50%. So we can come to the conclusion and some recommendations for you. So 50% of nodes are reliable, and packet loss really highly depends on the structure of the building and the number of the walls and structure of the walls, and also percentage of open space between the devices that are communicating together. Some future readings, inspiration for you, and some next research. Research leads to add more nodes and increase further increase precision of analysis. We will also do some analysis of signal over the multiple floors. So if it is the same as through the wall, we can use a directional antenna for higher signal strength. And probably the last part would be analysis or find the best place to place the central unit. So the place would be with the lowest packet loss, and we can then change power of the signal of nodes to reduce power consumption of the nodes, because power consumption of nodes are highly depending on power of the signal. So some recommendations for indoor applications and ESP now. You should divide the building to segments with the highest percentage of open space, and maybe usage of multiple central units. And also central units can communicate by ESP now, but you should use probably directional antenna, and implementation of a software control of packet delivery, and then some solving of the issue if there is a non-delivery status. Thanks for watching.